Okie dokie. It's a new day, and I'm talking to myself in the camera. And apparently somebody got into our house, or tried, while we were gone. How can you believe that, dude? First night, kind of sucks. But that's okay. We don't know, because there's not a camera in that area, which kind of sucks. But Ashley's going to be coming, so she's going to check it out. Fingers crossed we don't lose our stuff, or else streams are going to be canceled for a pretty good while. Brush my teeth, though. This is the move today. Better buy cool stuff. We're going to get, what the fuck are they called in English?
What?
Pitayas?
Pitayas.
Pitayas? Pitayas? Just pitayas, yeah. So if you translate it, it's dragon fruit, but it's not dragon fruit. Like, it's better than dragon fruit.
It's still pitaya.
It's still pitaya? Really? Oh, never mind.
Dragon fruit is
pitaya. Yeah, dragon fruit is pitahaya, for everybody that doesn't know. So that's kind of a cool thing. And, yeah, you can't get this shit back in the States. It's really, really unfortunate.
Yeah, no, a bunch of smoothie places offer, like, imitation smoothie, pitaya smoothies, but it's, like,
it's not the same.
That's not it.
Yeah, it's kind of dog water. Okay, let me put you like this. If you see a white one, that's probably tuna or pitahaya. And then, yeah, or dragon fruit, whatever. And then these are always red. And they're really, really, like, a deep red. It's really nice. They're cute. Trust. Like, you'll love them. They don't taste like much, though. Personally, I don't think they taste like much. But if you look at dragon fruit is like a consistent, it's a single consistency. This stuff is like grainy, if that makes sense. It feels like you took a dragon fruit and then you put it through a meat grinder. And then, like, it came out in those little strands. It's really good, though. There you go. Oh, we got the fruits. Mary loved it. She says that they remind her of thighs or hamburger meat.
Oh, really?
Huh. Hey. Yeah.
No, como no, no me la puede perder.
Diga,
creen, they look pretty damn good, too. I'm gonna get shot. Let's see. All of that comes from those really pointy cactus. They're fucking awesome. Holy shit, they got a lot too. Oh, hog tons, holy shit. A bunch of tiny ones. There's only a handful of big ones. Usually when they're really big, when they're super big, is when they're just right. Because then all of the seeds, all the pricks fall off on their own. And the skin tears, which is pretty awesome. But yeah, you can pick them a little early. They're still good. It's just kind of on the rough side, because sometimes you'll get the sour patch. It sucks.
You can have it all.
Yeah.
Yeah, check it out.
I just want a piece.
Get a bite. Oh yeah, see? Look, see, it's all grainy and like brainy. They're awesome, though. I'm glad Dad likes them. You're good?
En español es la fruta de los dioses. That was so good. One bite?
I can't. I wish. Oh, I wish. I love these things. Yeah, no. No, these will fuck me up.
A loopy.
Nah.
What if I get you soda?
If you get me a soda, yeah, I'll eat one.
All right, we'll do it at home. So you don't feel bad
there. But yeah, they're super awesome. I didn't know that they had them. Look. Oh, yeah, that's yeah, see? So these are all the ones with the pricks.
Right.
See?
Look at this point. This how they come
so off. How did he take them off?
Okay, so here's like the thing, that's the stick, and then you strip it off, just to clean it like that. So this is how they come
out. So that's how they look like, and that's how they come out. Normally, when they're fully ripened, that's when all the pricks start falling off. But they're pretty fucking awesome. Dad always buys a fuck ton of them.
It does remind you of
Brain. It does remind you of
Brain.
It's like really veiny. This is nice. There we go. Just want to show you guys the front. It's so big. I don't think I have super view on, which is unfortunate. But still, it's fucking badass. It's so big and cute, and there's always like beautiful stained glass art. on the front and all the windows. It's really pretty.
That's good.
We got our fruit. We got some weird things that are really starchy. And I used to eat them all the time too, but I can't eat them now. Because, you know.
Junior dropped the pataya.
Life's a bit, you bitch. Okie dokie. So, we just left my grandparents' house, which is cool. It's nice seeing them. And now, we're on our way to the other house, the nice house. I'm gonna give you guys a cool little tour of that house. It's nothing like huge, but it's pretty cute. First, we got food. Ain't that right, Mercator? Food first. And then we're gonna be getting set up because Saturday we're going to have some cool food for my mom because it's gonna be her birthday. So it's gonna be lit. I think we're doing pretty good though. I'm probably gonna end up sleeping a fuck ton. So we'll see. Plus, this is, by the way, like, I guess, what would we call this today? Day one? Yeah, I guess it's day one.
Officially day one, because yesterday was just flying.
Yeah, it was literally, we spent the entire day flying.
Pretty much.
It was not. We technically didn't sleep for 24 hours.
That's true.
Because we got up at 5.
That's
12. No. I mean, like yesterday.
No,
not yesterday, the day before. Tuesday, we got up at 6, or we got up at 5, because we had to go into work around 7-ish. So we got up at 5, and then we got all our things, did our work day, finished packing, and then at midnight, we went to the airport. So we got our stuff ready, so we go to the airport, and got to load in the car, stuff. And then it was just waiting and flying and waiting and flying and driving. And from that point until 6:30, because we like left at 5:30, like we boarded our flight at 5:30. It had been a full 24 hours. I was just like, yeah, this kind of fucking sucks. I need sleep. And then we slept on the plane and we slept while Dad drove. And that was pretty much it. It was cool though. Can't say I wasn't impressed with the flying. Usually there's a fuck ton of turbulence, but we had a good time. Hi, Dickie. My bag, excuse me. Let's get a shot on my grandpa. We played some Alcatraz. It's nice.
What'd they do?
The
flowers, I love them.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at the Day of the Dead one. Who did
That's
that?
Pretty. It's still raining a little bit. ¿Quieres que les carguen un poco?
They're filled with
dirtish? I think so. The book used to... No, it was always there. They broke it, though. During construction, or of it, I guess.
They redid it.
It was vandalized.
Oh, there you go. Somebody vandalized it.
We know who it was.
Yeah, well, we don't know who it was, but we know who it was.
There
Bastards.
You go.
Yeah.
Wink. I'll tell you guys later. Maybe. Probably not. Because people are snooty. You used to have a grave kind of like that. But it was a shared grave.
No.
Just like a bunch of these are. And yeah, we eventually got the money together and we put this guy up.
Oh, yeah.
Is this just Grandpa?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Yeah, because you used to share it with my aunt.
With your aunt.
So. I passed away as well. And it's really nice. A lot of people go all out. There's a handful that are just as pretty. Some that look a little prettier. This, the graveyard area. Here's an open one.
Under construction. Can I see?
Yeah, they're digging over there right now.
Oh, I see.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's a
big family one. Yeah. They're expanding them. They used to be just like that. One single hole. But that one right there had like three compartments, I guess.
The other one had like six compartments.
Yeah. And I have a couples one right here.
This one. This is a couple.
Yeah, Mia's kind of weird. She loves the graves.
I love them.
Like, I'm just like, oh, it's fucking weird. But I mean, I don't know, I guess. There's something pretty about it. Shut the fuck up. Respect the dead. God damn it. He had a pocket. You need some bitches while you're still alive, damn it. The man's got no game. I thought I didn't have game. This guy. I'm just kidding. That was rude.
They're fucking gross too.
I know. For some other people, reason, people, oh yeah, that one was a baby. really makes me think about life and death and how there's life and death, I guess. I don't know.
I could really use a cheeseburger.
Yeah, food sounds pretty good right now. See, there's that one. It's really pretty.
See, I kind of prefer this because then the U.S., you really just get, like, that plaque on the ground.
Yeah, I don't know. The plaque's weird.
The most ghetto shit I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't spare a single dime here. I like it.
See,
as sad as it is.
The blue one's around here somewhere.
No, the blue one's gone. Yeah, blue one's gone.
It's this one.
Yeah, they try to make it pretty, the basic grave. They try to make it pretty by painting it. It was just a big blue fucking grave. Oh. And here's the shared one. There you go, for my aunts. This is where the original one used to be.
They got rid of the flowers. The ones that that were sent here from other people.
Well, they always get rid of them.
Ah, man. It's pretty, right? Alrighty. On that sad note, we're now in my mom's town.
Oh, I like that.
And they're pride-friendly.
I love it.
I think.
I think.